You join us at the Circolo Italia for the final of the sailing at this 30th Universiade. Eight teams from seven nations competing. They came through qualifying, and that is how they line up. The boats have been assigned. Singapore 1 will be in blue, Germany in red, Australia in yellow, and so on. The clock counting down to the first of four races that will decide the medals here at the 30th Universiade. And race number one is away, with Singapore on the blue boat coming towards us on this pin end of the line, followed by the Australians, the overall leaders. Singapore 1 starting the day, fifth overall. Now, the left side of the course has paid dividends in earlier racing. But the boats at the moment seem to be choosing to go, well, pretty much up the middle of the course. The pink boat of Finland, second overall, start today, start this final just a point behind the Australians. Gillian Lee helming for Singapore. One of two female skippers in this final. It's mixed crews, two men, two women. And the German boat also being helmed by a female skipper, Johanna Meyer. And they are in the red boat with the number two on the bow. Right, there we go. We can see who has the early advantage about halfway up this first leg, and it's Austria out in front, with the Australians struggling in that yellow boat. So one final manoeuvre from that leading boat. That's the Finns, and the Austrians right beside them. So Finland have the lead. The skipper loses his hat. The Austrian is round in second. Then come the Russians. And then it's the Japanese. So our leading boats are round that top mark, heading downwind for the first time. Bay of Naples. That's a hugely rich sailing pedigree. 15 kilometres wide along the southwestern coast of Italy. It's hosted the 1960 Summer Olympics as boat number two from Germany jibes and we will see now, as they approach this gate on the right-hand side of the screen, who has the lead. And it is Finland that reaches that bottom gate, ahead of the Austrians and just ahead of the Germans. They get to choose which of these two marks they can round. But look how close it is at the halfway stage of this race. Talking to some of these skippers, they were saying that upwind, it can be hard to keep the speed in the chop here in the bay. But downwind, a very easy boat to sail. So the Japanese only now reaching that gate. But look at our overall leader still completing that first downwind leg. The Australians right at the back. Finns have the slightest of advantage over the Austrians right now. At the moment, they're following each other up this left-hand side of the course. They're going to have to tack in. There's a penalty claim there from boat number five. The Austrians. So what will happen is that the umpire boats that are following the fleet will judge on that and will give a verdict. I'm just looking to see if a penalty's been handed out, we would see one of these boats doing a penalty turn. I can't see that anywhere on the screen at the moment. So maybe the penalty was declined as they reach the top mark. Look how close it is, bow to bow, the Finns and the Austrians. Who is going to come out on top? There's just one leg left of this first race of the grand final. See the finish line coming into shot very soon. And the two boats behind them fighting it out for third are Germany and Singapore One. So they pass the bottom gate and the finish line just on the right-hand side here. We're going to see another manoeuvre from the Austrians. And that gives the Finns the edge. And Oskari Muhonen of Finland drives his boat across the finish line ahead of the Austrians. Stefan Scharnagel will take second at the helm of the black boat. And now let's see who's won this battle for third. It's between the Singaporeans and the Germans, and I think that's boat number one. Singapore One takes the third place finish ahead of Germany. And that is the result of the race we've just seen. So Finland, Austria taking first and second. The hooter goes. And Singapore One were away. Ah, yes, there. I thought that might be Singapore over early, and someone has been recalled to restart for crossing the line early. But it's not the Singaporeans going back. Well, we'll have to wait for confirmation. To find out who exactly was over the line early. But the fleet heading upwind towards the yellow mark at the top of the course. Windward leeward course, two laps, and now the Australians going back and starting again. Well, the Austrians have managed five victories in qualifying. Two second places, two third places. So a whopping nine podium finishes for the Austrians in qualifying. But that was still only good enough to send them into this final in fourth place. But they're turning it around now. So Scharnagel at the helm does it again. The 23-year-old leads his team around that top mark in first place. Russians are second. Then come the Finns. So our leaders coming to the bottom gate. And the two boats just behind them, Finland and Singapore, one. And really, for the medals, the Finns just have to keep an eye on the Austrians, just have to stay in touch, make sure they don't get away, don't get too many boats between themselves. And the gold medal will belong to Finland. Here's Singapore, one. Dropping that spinnaker. There was there's an umpire on one of those umpire boats holding up a signal. So there's been a slight wind change and they will be heading to a different top mark now, heading for the red one. And it's interesting how different teams have come together. The Russians, for example, were formed from different teams in the Russian Sailing League. And then as once formed, they had to beat six other teams to qualify. Whereas some teams have been chosen as their national university champions, others have been chosen from different universities based on their success in other classes. But being very successful at the moment in this race are the Austrians and the Finns as they come into the top mark in a position that we are used to seeing them in. First and second. So the Austrians have the advantage. The Finns rounding just now. Then come Singapore one. Singapore two, I'm sorry. Singapore one coming in fourth. So we have the Austrians out in front, but the chasing pack are closing in on them. And I think the Finns and the Singaporeans are running out of racetrack to overhaul the Austrians for a race win. But there's still plenty of water there between themselves and the finish line. But they're going well, they're going steadily. And you know, when the boats reach that bottom gate, it's just a few more meters to the finish line. It looks from this picture that the Finns are in second place. And Singapore two are in third. The Austrians with Stefan Scharnagl at the helm cross the finish line in first place to win race three of the four that make up the final. Hanna Ziegler, Johanna Daum and Louis Wenger-Uhn, the other crew members celebrating on that Austrian boat. And they'll feel confident now that maybe in that final race they could just do enough to overhaul the Finns and take the gold. And there's just 5 points between the Austrians and the Finns overall. 44 seconds to go to the start. The Australians who are in the yellow boat are the closest to chasing the Singaporeans for that bronze medal. And they're currently there in the middle of the line. As the clock counts down, the Australians made a terrible error on the start and had to go back and start again in the previous race, so they won't want to make that mistake again. We'll hear the hooter any second now to release these boats. There it is, the race is away. And And it's the Singaporeans closest to us with a good start, the Australians as well, with bow number three. And I don't think there are any recalls. But Singapore one, out of the blocks, leading the fleet, upwind for the first time. It's two laps, or four legs, two upwind, two downwind. And it's currently Singapore one, followed by Australia, and then Singapore two in third. These are our overall leaders, the Finns. Oskari Muhonen, the Olympic sailor, at the helm. Now, we're at the top mark now. The Finns coming in, our overall leaders, but they come in behind Singapore one. Singapore one out of the medals as things stand. Sailing for pride. Here come the Austrians. The Austrians need to get in front of the Finns, and they need to get five boats between themselves and the Finns in order to snatch the gold from Muhonen. Right now, that's looking like a tall order. There's a penalty there on board the Japanese boat. There was an infringement at the mark. Penalty complete, and they continue their race as we watch our race leader from Singapore. So there we see the bottom gate coming to the conclusion of the first downwind leg of this final deciding race in the mixed fleet racing here at the 30th Universiad. The RS21, really good boat to sail downwind. The skippers were telling me yesterday they've had a really good time with that. Hard to keep speed upwind in some of the chop, but we're not seeing the seas that we've seen in previous days. The wind's relatively light here in the bay today. And the Austrians have taken the lead. So the Austrians, chasing gold, are round in first. So where are the Finns? There they are, and the Finns currently in third. The Germans making their way up to that top mark. Singapore two, with Gillian Lee at the helm. Can they do enough? Can they hold on to that bronze medal to claim a medal for Singapore at the Universiad in sailing? Well, this is another team with a female helm, Johanna Meyer from Rostock University. Studies biomedical engineering. Very active in the German National League sailing J70s. Trying to take her German team up through the fleet, currently sitting in fourth. There is the Castel dell'Ovo. Why is it called an egg castle? It's connected to a legend which states that Virgil, that's the Roman poet, not the Thunderbird's puppet, placed a magic egg within the castle's foundations. And it says that should the egg ever be broken, the castle and the city of Naples would fall. Well, it hasn't happened for over 2,000 years. Despite the ominous presence of Vesuvius overlooking the bay. These are our overall leaders. It's so close coming up to this top mark for the second time. It's really building up to a terrific climax on the final leg. And we may see some penalties inflicted here. The Austrians reach that mark first. Then come two Singaporean boats. And also the Finns. So the Finns are round in second. That's all they need to do to hold on to the gold medal. They just need to stay in touch with the Austrians. Singapore one around, Singapore two around. These are the Russians. So as we head towards the finish line, the medal positions are gold for Finland, silver for Austria, and bronze for Singapore two. Germans were taking a penalty turn there, and they have dropped down towards the back of the fleet now. These are the leading two boats in the race. The Australians back in the mix there on that far side of the course. But it's all eyes on number five, and to the left of the screen, the pink boat, number six. Here are our overall leaders. Saw Alex Gromblom, the tactician, just looking out, keeping an eye on the opposition. And the Sandman sisters, who match race and sail 49ers together, and really showing how important teamwork and experience is. Finland with two victories and a second place finish already in this four race final. Head towards the finish line. And the Austrians should be somewhere just in front of them. No, they've gone behind. So the Finns have taken the lead at the end of this very final leg of this final race. It is Finland out in front. It's where they have been all day in the final. Finland take victory in the final race. They take victory overall. It's gold for Finland. And Oskari Muhonen, their Olympic sailor, takes a gold medal for the country, Finland's first and only so far at the 30th Universiad. The Austrians cross in second place, that'll be a silver for them. And Singapore too, cross the line in third place. That should be enough to get the Singaporeans a bronze medal. So Finland won the final race, Austria were second, Singapore two were third. So Finland take gold, Austria silver, and Singapore two take the bronze medal.